Buffaloes are most versatile animals with enormous adaptability potential to varied climate, better feed conversion efficiency from poor quality roughages and higher resistance to diseases. India has over 98 million buffaloes and they constitute about 57% of the total world buffalo population. Buffaloes are considered to be triple-purpose animals. Primarily as a dairy animal for milk production, the surplus males and spent buffaloes used for meat and bullocks are used for draft purpose, especially for pulling load and field operations. The contribution of buffaloes in Indian economy is immense. Despite being lower in number, that is 98 million, than cattle, that's 184 million, buffaloes currently produce about 55% of the total 108 million metric tons milk produced in the country. About 25% of total 6.2 million metric tons meat and 10% of total draft power contributed by work animals in India. In addition to milk, meat and draft, buffaloes also provide 0.52 million metric tons of skin and hides to the leather industry. In order to undertake research on various aspects of buffalo production, the Central Institute for Research on Buffaloes was established on 1st February 1985 by the ICAR.
The institute has completed 25 years of its existence and has in February 2010 has celebrated its silver jubilee year. The research activities at the institute are being undertaken in three divisions, namely buffalo genetics, breeding and management, buffalo nutrition, buffalo physiology and reproduction. The research is conducted under program mode in all these three divisions, and the major achievements so far: under protein testing program at the institute, test mating from 11 sets of bulls has been completed and 12th set was initiated in January 2010 and shall continue up to June 2011. 7 sets of bulls have been protein tested and 19 top ranking bulls have been identified for nominated mating, and 50,000 doses from these bulls are available with the institute for sale to different agencies. 439 breeding bulls of superior genetic merit have been disseminated to the village panchayats, to animal husbandry departments and other agencies involved in buffalo improvement. Institute has developed area specific mineral mixture for improving the reproductive efficiency as well as improving the production, and at present the major thrust areas of research are to undertake research on buffalo genomics for identification of molecular markers for marker assisted selection in buffaloes, and for this research activities have already started in association with NBAGR Karnal. Then sexing of semen to have the calf of desired sex, then embryo transfer technology for faster multiplication of superior germplasm, development of economical and balanced ration for milk and meat production, progeny testing for genetic improvement in buffaloes involving farmers animals under the network project on buffalo improvement.
A sub-campus of the institute was established at Nabha, Punjab on 1st December 1987 by acquiring 588 acres of land and other facilities from the government of Punjab. The objective of the sub-campus is to establish an elite herd of Neeli Ravi buffaloes for the production of genetically superior animals for overall improvement of the breed. Genetic resource improvement is the major program to undertake studies on genetic improvement of Murrah breed at the main campus and Neeli Ravi at its sub-campus Nabha. Genetic improvement is targeted through associated herds progeny testing, performance recording and genetic analysis of data, buffalo genomics, identification of molecular markers for MAS are the focused programs.
few modern technologies in molecular genetics field. In other animal kingdom species, the marker-assisted selection has been introduced, based on which the early selection is possible. In this particular lab, the PCR-based characterization of the DNA of buffalo is going on to identify the molecular markers, which are the basic requirements to develop the marker-assisted selection programs for buffaloes.
Feed resource utilization and improvement is the major program. Studies have been undertaken on rumen ecosystem to identify rumen microflora with improved activity and develop economical and balanced rations. Experiments are also being undertaken to work out nutrient requirements of buffaloes for milk, meat and draft for different categories of animals, and evaluation of different feed and fodder ingredients available with farmers in different regions.
The main thrust area of Buffalo Nutrition Division is to improve the available feed resources and nutrient utilization for enhancing buffalo production. To overcome the problem of mineral deficiencies in this area, we have specially formulated this area-specific mineral mixture, which contains all these essential minerals required for buffalo production. We have commercialized this mineral mixture, and now we are selling it at the rate of 32 rupees per kg at no profit, no loss basis for the farmers. If this mineral mixture is supplemented in the animal ration at farmer's doorstep, can improve the buffalo production and its fertility.
Improvement of reproductive efficiency program has been the main focus of the division, which includes male and female infertility, seminology, artificial insemination, reproductive biotechnology, as well as mammary gland development and function, embryo biotechnology, stem cell and semen sexing are the frontline areas of research.
Thrust areas of research in physiology and reproduction include increasing reproductive efficiency of female buffaloes, frozen semen technology and reproductive biotechnologies. With ultrasonographic monitoring, we found that the problem is due to the absence of ovulation of a mature follicle, probably due to inherent hormonal deficiencies in buffaloes. The technique of ultrasonography has been applied for early pregnancy diagnosis, fetal sex determination and for studying udder health and development. In the near future, we plan to undertake work on semen sorting based on X and Y bearing spermatozoa, so that the two populations are separated and the farmer can get his buffaloes inseminated with either X-bearing spermatozoa or Y-bearing spermatozoa, so as to achieve the progeny or the calf of his own choice. Work has also been initiated on stem cell technology.
Stem cells have the capacity to self-renew and can make the cells of other types or other tissues in the body. In this laboratory, we are working on adult stem cells, and our main source or origins for the stem cells are amniotic fluid, umbilical cord, matrix and fetal explants.
Semen freezing program is an important component of the institute, with ultra-modern facilities in the semen freezing lab. The lab looks after semen collection, cryopreservation and distribution from genetically superior breeding buffalo bulls. Frozen semen is provided at a nominal price to the developmental agencies, farmers and inseminators engaged in buffalo improvement program in the country. The lab has a stock of more than 3 lakh doses of frozen semen from about 150 breeding bulls, out of which more than 50,000 doses are of progeny tested bulls. Frozen semen doses prepared from farmers' prize-winning superior bulls are also available with the institute, and these are distributed to the inseminators for buffalo improvement program. Farmers of Haryana as well as other states are being benefited in terms of improvement in their buffaloes breed by using the frozen semen from this institute.
Bulls are selected on the basis of their pedigrees and dam sealed, and on the basis of the true to breed Murrah buffalo phenotypic characters.
Sound health of buffaloes is very important for their better productivity and performance.
the buffaloes are regularly vaccinated to protect them from different diseases. The important diseases of buffaloes are foot and mouth disease, hemorrhagic septicemia, black water and brucellosis. The vaccination for foot and mouth disease is done in the winter season during the months of January or February, while the vaccination for hemorrhagic septicemia and black water is done before the onset of monsoon season in the month of May or June. Periodic monitoring of buffaloes is also done for different diseases like tuberculosis, Jaundice disease and mastitis.
We also take transfer of technologies in the field area on the different technology developed at the institute on artificial insemination, balanced feeding, area specific mineral mixture, selection of breeding bulls for improved productivity, healthcare and vaccination.
Institute is engaged in extension activities for propagation of knowledge on buffalo breeding, feeding, reproduction, health and management to the farmers through regular visits by the scientists or technical personnel in 8 adopted villages, organizing trainings, demonstrations, lectures, calf rallies and treatment camps.
In this program, so far, we have done more than 14,000 artificial inseminations in villages. We had a conception rate of about 48%.
Organization of Buffalo Mela at the Institute premises is annual feature. Large number of farmers bring their prized animals and take part in competitions under different categories. Central Institute for Research on Buffaloes endeavors to serve the farmers and is dedicated to the cause of buffalo improvement in the country.